Hi, hello everybody. This is Dr. G.P. Sudhakar, Professor of Management from Hyderabad, India. Right, so in this specific video, we are going to discuss how to do secondary research. How to do secondary research. See, this video can be applicable to doing research in management discipline or social sciences. It can be applied to social sciences as well. Right. See, so our main objective is to learn how to do secondary research. Doing secondary research in management. Secondary research in management. That's what we would like to do, right? So, see, basically when we talk about secondary research, right? See, what is secondary information is? Secondary information is already published source of information. See, what is the source to secondary research? Secondary research. What are the different sources of secondary research? First, journals. Next, magazines, business magazines like, you know, Forbes or Inc. Fortune, this Business India, this kind of Business India, Business Today, this kind of magazines, right? And sometimes if you are finance domain, Value Research, one of the beautiful publication from Edelweiss Financial Services. Value Research also gives some of the research inputs. The Dalal Street, Indian equity markets information will be there. Different business magazines, right? So they can also become your sources of research. So next, what? No, another trade publications, are published by different bodies. NASSCAM or CII, Confederation of Indian Industry, so like different associations, bodies, what they publish, SPIN, these kind of what publish, they publish. Sometimes other consulting companies, reports, databases of the, you know, databases, right? So these will become the sources of information for you. Databases like RBI database, SEBI database, RBI, BSE, United Nations, World Bank, these kind of databases. Right. So they all will become sources of information for you. Secondary information means already published data. So what is your main objective? You want to do secondary research. What is the meaning of it? Extract the information already is there in the information. Extract the hidden patterns in the information from the already existing data. Extract the hidden patterns in the data which data is already available. That's what is the main objective of secondary research. That means it involves discovery. Means already it is there. That information, hidden information in the data. So we have to apply different techniques and do the secondary research. See, secondary research can be, when you do secondary research, it can be four or five types are there. So first one is conceptual study. I will take you through examples also. One example I will explain you, okay, don't worry. So first one is conceptual study. Second one is review based study. And third one is a perspectives. Writing your perspective, right? Perspectives. This is fourth secondary research, this thing, right? And fourth one is a critic. Writing a critic. This could be secondary research. Right. So, like this, secondary research can be categorized. First one is conceptual study, second one is review-based study, and third one is perspectives. What is your perspective on certain research area or research topic? Next one is critic. Right. So, these kind of secondary research can be done. Right. The output of each one is different. Output what comes out of each type of research is different. Right, I will explain you what is that. See, first conceptual study. What is the main objective of conceptual study? You want to find out what is the origin of a concept. What is the origin of a concept? You know, concept. You will dig into different definitions. Origin of a concept. What is the origin of a concept? You take, organizational performance is one concept. Organizational performance. Or, customer satisfaction, one concept. What is another concept? Another innovation. Innovation, one concept. Product, it can be concept. Theoretically, it is a concept, right? Product means what? There is a definition for product. Similarly, process, concept. Management definition is there for process. Like that, you identify what is a concept. You want to, conceptual study, right? What is the origin of it? What is its definition? What is its definition? Right. Definition means what all will come? What is the concept, main concept I am studying? What are the components of it? What are the components? What is the sub-concept inside it? What it constitutes? What it constitutes? When I say organizational performance means what? Achieving organizational financial performance, customer satisfaction, employee satisfaction. It includes all that, right? That means when I define organizational performance means organizational performance includes customer satisfaction, employee satisfaction, employee performance and achieving financial objective and societal goal. That is my definition. That means what are all, they are all the components of that definition of the concept. Right. So, digging like this is nothing but a conceptual study. Is nothing but the conceptual study. You may define a new concept from making use of the existing concepts. Making use of the existing concepts by evidence of the literature, you will be defining a new concept. By keeping the evidence of previous literature, you will be defining a new concept. For example, you have defined a new concept using existing literature, that can be become input to this primary research. That can become input to the primary research. You can empirically prove whatever you have defined is correct or not based on the conceptual thing. Right. That is one type of secondary research. That is one type of secondary research. What is the another type of secondary research? This is a review-based study. This is very much important. You know, hidden facts will be available with a review-based study. You know, I have experienced review-based studies. I have done several review-based studies. I will share that example also. Right. See, review-based study, what is that? It involves gathering of the different journal articles. Different journal articles are, newspaper articles, magazine articles like that, right? So, in what is the main output of review-based study? Main output of review-based study can be conceptual model. Conceptual model. Output of review-based study. What do you do in review-based study? You gather 30-40 articles. Each article, what is the research they have done? What variable they used? What is the conceptual model? What is the finding? I will note down in the literature review. Right. Next, I will use it as input to the conceptual development. Next, I will define the hypothesis. Hypothesis or propositions. Or propositions. I will make the proposition. This is the, that's all. It is a review-based study. With this, you will stop. Review-based study, what do you do? You will read the literature, make it used for development of a conceptual model, and then define the, propose the hypothesis and close it there. That is the secondary research. You stop it there. This becomes input to the primary research. This again becomes input to the primary research. So this is one way of doing secondary research. I will give one example also for this. Just be with me. So this is one of the secondary based research type known as review based study, right? So next one is what? Perspectives. Perspective means you study different articles on the coming from the different researchers across the world. You collect the data, and then, for example, you have done earlier research on similar topics. Similar topics. So right. So you include other researchers' findings. Other researchers' findings. And include your findings also. Your findings. And say, this is my perspective. This is my perspective. Or you have done empirical study earlier. What are the findings? That you specify. Only these are the findings whatever I have got. That is your perspective based on your previous studies. Your opinion. Your opinion about one topic or one research area. Next one comes critic. Critic means what? For example, some researchers across the world, they have found out something. They have proposed something or, you know, or they have proposed something or their research findings are some topics, some findings are there, other researchers' findings. You will agree or disagree to them and write a critic. What is the merit in that? What is the merit in the other researchers' findings? What is the demerit in that? Demerit in that. Demerit of other researchers' findings. Other researchers' findings. Merit of other researchers' findings and demerit of other researchers' findings. Right. That is about a critic. Critics will be a bit brief. Briefer. Usually critics are brief. And perspectives are also, you know, up to 10-15 pages it runs. Review based studies will be a bit larger and concepts will also larger. See, across the world, if you take secondary research based studies are widely cited research to compare with empirical studies because of one reason. That is, they are complete in because secondary research based studies are, you know, comprehensive. Whatever literature review secondary research will do, they are comprehensive. Secondary research based articles. That is the reason they are highly cited. That is the reason they are highly cited. Right. So, like this, there are four different types of research we can do with respect to secondary research and literature based studies. Right. So, what is the output of conceptual study? A new concept we will define. Output of review-based study is a model we will develop and we will define the hypothesis. Next, concept of output of perspectives, we will, tell based on our findings, some perspective we will tell. So, next, critic means we will highlight the merits and demerits of other researchers. So, this is the output of critic. Like this, that is the output of secondary research. Right. So, these things can become step first type and second type can become input to the primary research. They can become input to the primary research. Right. So, as an example, I will explain to you review based study. One example I will take and I will take you through an example review based study. Right. It is a secondary research based study. For example, you want to find out a review of factors contributing to organizational effectiveness. Review of factors contributing to organizational effectiveness. That is your research topic. That is your research. This is broader topic, right? Example is what? Review of factors. Review of factors contributing. Review of factors contributing to organizational effectiveness. This is your research topic. This is what is secondary research, review based study you want to conduct. want to conduct a review-based study. Review of factors contributing to organizational effectiveness. But what you have to do? You have to search articles in the Google or DOAJ, Director of Open Access Journals, or Google Scholar, or Microsoft Academic Search, or any other databases if your organization providing those databases, Emerald, Elsevier Journals, IGA, or Springer's. You know, you take quality journals, right? And then collect the research articles by using different keywords. Factor contributing to organizational effectiveness, reasons for organizational effectiveness. No, you have to use different technique and different keywords and collect the data, collect the articles. So a count of 50 to 60 reference articles, 50 to 60 plus would be ideal case for this kind of review based study. 60 articles would be ideal case, 50 to 60 for this kind of review based study, right? So what is that you are getting out of this review based study? You will get what could be the objective we can get. I will tell you the process. Top 5 factors contributing to the organizational effectiveness. We can get, based on this research, what is that I am going to explain. We can get top 5 factors contributing to the organizational effectiveness, number 1. Number 2, we will come to know what are the different categories of factors impacting organizational effectiveness. What will be the different categories of factors impacting organizational effectiveness? Right, these two can be found with the method I am going to explain to you. Right, so this is review based study, just to follow me. First one is what? Review of factors. See, you have collected articles, right? 56 articles you have collected. Then, while going through the article, what you have to do? You have to underline which factor is contributing to the organizational effectiveness. Sometimes it may be saying that so and so factor, for example, employee performance, employee productivity, or manager leadership style is impacting the organizational performance or organizational productivity. That kind of sentence will be there. Then you underline that factor, whether it is employee performance, productivity, or it is manager style or organizational structure. Organizational structure is contributing to organizational performance or financial performance. There is a sentence in one research paper. Then you underline the organizational structure. So like that, what you have to do? You, after underlining in the research paper, you have to put a table like this. To put a table, what you have to do? First, include the factor. First column is factor. Right. So next one is reference. Next one is count. Total count. What you have to do? For each first factor you identified is employee productivity. Employee productivity is impacting organizational effectiveness. Employee productivity. This is the first factor you identified. Right. Put it in as serial number 1. Serial number. You include serial number. First factor. Okay. Like this, if you collect the second factor can be leadership style of the manager. Leadership style. This is also contributing to organizational effectiveness. This is second factor. Similarly, you will get organization structure. It can be from 8th item probably. Okay. Organizational structure. This is one factor. This is one factor you identified. Then what do you do? While you are reading research paper, you have marked, right, which factor is impacting organizational effectiveness. You have noted down here, right? Against that you specify. What is the who is the researcher who has mentioned that article name? You specify X and here. His name is probably some X. Okay, I don't want to name specific people. See, X or year, probably 1970. Similarly, Y, 2010. Similarly, Z, 2015. So, X, Y, Z, these three researchers have quote, have said that this factor is impacting the organizational effectiveness. Similarly, leadership style, probably some person A in 2005 he specified, person B he specified in 1985, person C specified in 1990 in one of the paper. Leadership style is affecting organizational effectiveness. So like this, for each paper For example, for first factor, you include one more also, you know, p probably 2011, right? So like this, after entering all the factors, you will get a minimum 100 factors. You will get 100 factors affecting the organizational effectiveness. If you place 90 to 100 factors will be there, which are affecting the more than 100 factors affecting the organizational performance. Investor factors are there, customer factors, vendor factors, you know, regulatory factors, organizational effectiveness. You know, so many factors will come. So I will tell you how to do that. Right. So each factor you specify and mention the references in which it was cited. It was cited. So count them at the end of the exercise after all 60 papers studying is over from you. After this table is prepared, you count this. How many this has got? How many references are there here? 4 people have cited this factor. Example. Similarly, here 3 people. Probably organization structure only AB in 1990. Only 1% has specified organization structure. Or, you know, there can be 5 items. Let us say 6 people have specified organization structure. 6 people have specified organization structure. Right. Then what do? You rank order the factors in decreasing order. You have got, right, this total count. How many references are there? You count it. Right. You rank order the factors in decreasing order of number of citations. Right. So first one, what is it coming? If you rank order, decreasing order. Here, which factor is coming first? Organization. Which factor is coming first? Organization structure. 6 times. Next, employee productivity. 4 times it is referred. Next, leadership style is 3 times. Like this, in decreasing order of occurrence, decreasing order of number of citations of the specific factor in the literature, you specify. First 5 factors, what will they become? You specify, you know, decreasing order, right? For the entire table, you can arrange, you can have a additional table otherwise here itself. No, descending order, you know, then you have to write the factor number. Instead of that, this is best practice. You maintain another table. So, first 5 factors you identify which is the maximum number. You enter 5 factors. What is the number of occurrences in the literature? Frequency, right? So, what do you get at the end of the exercise? You got top 5 factors. You got top 5 factors contributing to the organizational effectiveness. Top 5 factors contributing to the organizational effectiveness. Then, next step, that answered our first question, right? You came to know by using reference count, you came to know top 5 factors contributing to organizational effectiveness. Next, what do? You identify similar factors. You identify, here employee productivity is there, right? For example, third factor is employee attitude. Third factor is employee attitude. Now, that also impacts organizational effectiveness, right? So, this is one paper has cited this. Then what do? You tick mark each one, right, employee related factors, and put it as employee factors. This is one category of factors. Next, leadership style of manager. This is what? This is manager. Similarly, organization structure, this is organizational characteristic factors. What all will come? Organizational culture, organization structure, organizational climate, organization size, that can also be, right? So, organization type, what is the nature of business they are doing? That is also one of the characteristic, right? That can also impact organizational effectiveness. If it is complex task, maybe effectiveness may be bit lower end, right? So, organizational characteristic. Next part, so similarly you can have vendor factors, customer factors, similarly you can have investor factors, similarly any other external factors. Example, regulatory aspects, tax related, bank, finance related, these kind of factors. So like this, what you have done, whatever are the similar factors, you have grouped them. You have grouped them into category of factors. category of factors. So these are the different categories of factors impacting the organizational effectiveness. Impacting the organizational effectiveness. You keep the variable here and say that this is the organizational effectiveness. What did you get? You got the categories of factors impacting the organizational effectiveness based on this this work. We have grouped the identical items, which are closer items. You have grouped them and then put it as a category of factors. Employee factors, manager factors, organizational characteristic factors, next customer factors, vendor factors, investors factors, and external factors. Any external factors, these are the categories of factors impacting organizational effectiveness. For example, CEO factors, that will also affect the organizational effectiveness. But here what we can do, instead of CEO factors, because too many categories of factors, if they have become, research will be, a little bit longer time it will take, scope will increase, right? Then keep CEO also as part of manager factors. Here is a manager, right? So you come under manager factors itself. Right. Like that, you have identified the different factors affecting the organizational effectiveness. Right. So this is how you do the research. Right. So with this review based research, what is that your contribution? You have identified what are the top 5 factors contributing to the organizational effectiveness and what are the categories of factors impacting organizational effectiveness. See, further research also can be done. What is that? Under each category of factors, which is the maximum cited factor among organizational factors? I will say that organizational structure is the most effective in the organizational effectiveness based on the maximum count. Now, in each category of factors, this factor is specific to this employee productivity is the most impacting the organizational effectiveness. One factor you can identify under each category of factors and say that under this category, this specific factor is mostly affecting the organizational effectiveness. So like this, you can do the research. So this comes under secondary research. Under secondary research, review based study. This is review based study. See, I personally have done for several papers, I have followed this model and I think it's good. Good one, you'll enjoy it. Right, so hope I was able to communicate whatever I thought of communicating. So this is about secondary research, right? Hope you will be able to understand. Okay, so just go through this, focus a couple of minutes and go through this table, right? So you will be able to see. Okay, thank you. Okay, let's move on to another task. Please focus for a couple of minutes.